Welcome to Technically Explained. This is Geometry Lesson 5, and in this lesson we are going to talk about circles. So this is part 1 of circles. We will have two parts of circles, that is part 1 and part 2. So what is a circle? A circle is a shape consisting of all the points in a plane that are a given distance from a given point, and that given point is called the center. Usually the center is denoted by O, and the distance and the radius is given is denoted by R, and diameter is twice the radius of the circle, and the total angle in a circle is 360 degrees. And then we have a chord. A chord is defined as a line segment formed by joining two points on a circle. Diameter is a chord that passes to the center of the circle, and remember that diameter is the longest possible chord. Area of a circle, as we all know, pi r square. Circumference of a circle is the 2 pi r. Now there is another important relationship, and this relationship is very important, and this is the relationship between the central angle and the arc length and the sector area. So center angle divided by 360 degrees equal to arc length divided by circumference of the circle divided by is equal to sector area divided by the circle of the whole area, and the circle of area is pi r square, circumference is 2 pi r. So using these relations we can always find the unknowns, how we will see in the coming examples. Now the radius of the circle is 8 centimeter. What is the area? So area is pi r square, as we discussed earlier. So we are going to put r is equal to 8 here, so we will get 64 pi. So the area of this circle is 64 pi, which was very easy. Again, another easy question, the radius of the circle is 8 centimeter. What is the circumference? Circumference is 2 pi r. So 2 pi into r, which is 8. So the circumference of this circle is 16 pi. So 16 pi is my circumference of this circle. Now we are getting to a bit of difficult question, which says the radius of the circle is 8 centimeter and the central angle is 45 degrees. What is the arc length by the central angle? The arc length is this length, which is xy. And what is the area of the sector xy? So this area is my area, this is my sector area. Whenever we find problems like these, we need to first calculate the area of the circle and the circumference of the circle. Since the radius is 8 centimeter, the circumference is 2 pi r is equal to 16 pi. So the circumference is 16 pi. And the next step, we are going to find the area. Area is pi r square, so area is 64 pi. Whenever we get questions like this, first we need to calculate the circumference and area so that our job is easy. Now after that we have calculated the circumference and area, let us first to the first point. What is the arc length made by the central angle? So we have to find the arc length, and we know the relationship that we discuss here, that central angle divided by 360 is equal to arc length divided by circumference. So we are going to use this relation, which is central angle divided by 360 is equal to arc length divided by circumference. So the central angle is given, which is 45 degrees. So 45 divided by 360 is equal to arc length, which is unknown, which is our unknown, because we need to find the arc length. So this is our unknown, let this be x, and then divide by circumference. Circumference we have found it earlier, which is 16 pi. So after solving this, if we solve this, we will get x is equal to 2 pi. X is equal to 2 pi. Because if we solve this, 45 adds there is 360. So this is 1 and this is 8. So if we solve this, we will get, if we then 16 pi will move to here, so we will get x is equal to 2 pi. So my arc length is 2 pi. So now the first one is done, so I can write here 2 pi. So I have solved the first one. Now the second is, what is the area of the sector x or y? So I have to find this area, and we know that to find the area of the circle, again we will use this relationship, which is central angle divided by 360 is equal to sector area divided by circle area, and we know that circle area. So we are going to come here. We know the central angle is 45 and the total angle is 360, and then we have the sector area which is unknown, let that be y, and then we have the total area which is 64 pi. So we are going to solve this again. 45 adds is 360. So when we solve this, we are going to get y is equal to, and then the 64 pi is going to move here, and 64 divided by 8 is 8. So we are going to get y is equal to 8 pi. So the area of this sector x of y is equal to 8 pi. So we are going to write 8 pi here. So this is our area, which is 8 pi. So that's how we are going to solve these questions using this relationship. This is a very important relationship. That's all for today. Thank you.